ஹியூமன் ரீப்ரொடக்ஷன் ஃபீமேல் ரீப்ரொடக்டிவ் சிஸ்டம் இந்த லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் வி ஆல்ரெடி டிஸ்கஸ்ட் அபவுட் த மேல் ரீப்ரொடக்டிவ் சிஸ்டம் டுடே வி ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் ஃபீமேல் ரீப்ரொடக்டிவ் சிஸ்டம் ஸோ ஃபீமேல் ரீப்ரொடக்டிவ் சிஸ்டம் கன்சிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஓவரிஸ் ஓவிடக்ட் இஸ் ஆல்சோ கால்ட் ஃபெலோபியன் டியூப் யூட்ரஸ் இஸ் ஆல்சோ கால்ட் வோம்ப் எக்ஸ்டர்னல் ஜெனிடாலியா தட் இஸ் வெஜினா மெமரி கிளாண்ட் So first of all, ovaries. From the plus one syllabus, we got that what is ovaries. Ovaries are the primary sex organ in females. It is the primary sex organ in females. Ovaries are located in the lower abdominal cavity. Ovaries are produced. Female gamete ovum and the estrogen progesterone. Ovaries are attached to the uterus and the pelvic wall by ovarian ligaments. And ovaries are measures about 2 to 4 centimeter length. That's all about the primary sex organ ovaries. And once again, ovaries are the primary sex organ in females. Ovary produce female gamete ovum and estrogen progesterone. Ovary are attached to the pelvic wall and uterus by ovarian ligaments and the ovaries are located in the lower abdominal cavity. Each ovary measures 2 to 4 cm in length. Second one, fallopian tube or oviduct. Oviduct or fallopian tube is a small tube measures 10 to 12 cm in length. The opening of fallopian tube, that we all know, this is uterus, this is the fallopian tube, and this is the ovary. Okay, then now we are discussing about this portion. Okay, the opening of the fallopian tube, this portion, is a funnel shaped structure. The opening of the fallopian tube is a funnel shaped structure, that is what called an infundibulum. Infundibulum. And the infundibulum has here some finger-like projections. The finger-like projections of the infundibulum are called fimbriae. Fimbriae close up to the ovary at the time of ovulation. At the time of ovulation, fimbriae close up to the ovary and collect ovum after ovulation. That is function of fimbriae. And the infundibulum leads into a wider path that is called an ampulla. So the next part is called an ampulla. Ampulla leads into a narrow path. This portion is called an isthmus. So this portion is ampulla and this is isthmus. And the junction between ampulla and isthmus is called a ampullary isthmic junction. Ampullary isthmic junction. And this region is suitable area for fertilization. So maybe a question, which region is suitable for fertilization? So the answer is ampullary isthmic junction is the suitable area for fertilization. And this ampullary isthmic junction or the isthmus leads into this portion. This is what called a uterus. So the next part is uterus. Uterus is also called a, we all know, uterus is also called a womb. It's also called a womb. And uterus is a hollow muscular inverted pear shaped stud, and the uterus has three regions important: outermost perimetrium, middle myometrium, innermost endometrium. So the perimetrium is the outermost layer and which covers the uterus, which covers the uterus. So maybe question, which region covers the uterus? So the answer is perimetrium is the outermost layer and which covers the uterus. And what is myometrium? Myometrium is the middle layer and which undergo severe contraction or strong contraction during parturition or delivery. Parturition. Okay, so which region undergoes severe contraction during parturition? So the myometrium is the layer, third layer. And endometrium. Endometrium is the innermost layer and the endometrium undergo cyclical changes. Cyclical changes during menses. Or during menstrual cycle, which layer of uterus undergo degeneration and regeneration? That is endometrium. Then the uterus leads into, this region is uterus, this uterus leads into cervix. The lower part of uterus is called a cervix. Cervix leads into a canal, that is called a cervical canal. Cervical canal. And this cervical canal leads into our next region, that is the external genitalia of the female, that is vagina. So for an important point, cervical canal along with the vagina, cervical canal along with the vagina are constituted as birth canal. Birth canal. So which one is known as birth canal? Cervical canal along with the vagina constitute as birth canal. That's all about the uterus. Next, external genitalia of the female, that is the vagina. Vagina consists of some parts. That is, first one is mons pubis. First one is mons pubis. Second one is labia majora. Third, labia minora. Clitoris. Hymen. These are the parts. And first one is mons pubis. Mons pubis is the cushion of fatty tissue. Cushion of fatty tissue where the pubic hair is present. So the mons pubis is the cushion of fatty tissue where skin is covered with the pubic hairs. Labia majora. Two folds of tissue. Two folds of tissue extends down from the mons pubis like this. Okay, two folds of tissue that extends down from the mons pubis is called a labia majora. Just inside the labia majora are labia minora. It is a paired, it is a paired folds of tissue present inside the labia majora. What is clitoris? Clitoris is finger like projections present in the upper portion of labia minora. That is what is called a clitoris. And the last one is called a hymen. Hymen is a soft membrane or thin soft membrane partially or entirely cover the vaginal mouth. So the vaginal mouth partially or entirely covered by hymen. So the hymen is often breaks during the first sexual intercourse. Hymen often breaks during the first sexual intercourse. So the hymen is taken as the virginity of the female. But one important point, hymen may be breaks during sporting. Sports like horse riding, sudden fall, cycling, etc. So hymen is not taken as the virginity of the female. The answer is hymen may be breaks during cycling, horse riding, sudden fall, etc. Okay, that's all about the hymen. And the last part in the female reproductive system is mammary gland, female breast. So we all know a pair of mammary glands are there in the female reproductive system. So the female reproductive system consists of a pair of mammary glands. So the mammary glands are composed of fatty tissue and glandular tissue. The female breast or the mammary gland is composed of fatty tissue and glandular tissue. Here the glandular tissue is divided into 15 to 20 mammary lobes. Important point, 15 to 20 mammary lobes. So the each lobe consists of group of alveoli. So the each alveoli opens into mammary tubules. Each alveoli opens into mammary tubules. Mammary tubules of each lobe opens into mammary duct. Several mammary duct joins to form a wider mammary ampulla. Several mammary ampulla. This mammary ampulla opens into lactiferous duct. Lactiferous duct. This is located just behind the nipple, through which the milk ejects outside. Okay, so that's all about the female reproductive system and the mammary gland.